Welcome to Power Electronics Lecture Series. In this session, I'll be going to explain isolated forward converter. Now, before I explain this circuit, as I have explained in last session, flyback converter. So, what are the difference which is there with isolated forward converter and flyback converter? So, if you see my previous session, circuit is almost same. There is only two difference which is there with flyback converter and this converter, isolated forward converter. One basic difference, that is this transformer. So when we talk about this transformer, winding of this transformer, that is in same direction. So dot, that will be there in same direction. So this is one difference. So what happens because of this dot polarity? When primary current is flowing, at the same time there will be a flow of secondary current. So, in flyback converter, we have seen when primary current is flowing at a time, we don't have secondary current. And when secondary current flows at a time, there is no primary current. So, that was the case which was there in flyback converter. But in isolated forward converter, we use such transformer which is having same direction winding. So, dot polarity, that is there in same direction. So, that explains when primary current flows, at the same time there will be a flow of secondary current. So this is one difference. And second difference is it is compulsory to use additional filter. So it is compulsory to use additional L filter in isolated forward converter. So these two basic differences are there. So let us mention it. One difference is same polarity of transformer, same polarity of transformer that we are using, and second is additional L filter. So this is the basic difference. Now, when we see this circuit, there will be few problem regarding this circuit at input side, and we can solve out that problem by connecting territory winding. So what is that problem? Let us discuss it first. So the basic problem is some residual energy that is remaining in the core of this transformer when switch is on. And as number of cycles are increasing, this residual energy in this transformer is increasing. So what happens is after few cycle, residual energy is more inside of this transformer, and that may damage this switch, which is what we are connecting over here. So to solve out that problem, we need to connect territory winding. So let us discuss this problem. In this circuit, some residual energy remains in the transformer core. And due to that, it increase with respect to number of cycle, and it will be saturating core of transformer. So due to this, transformer will saturated after few cycles, and this will overcurrent this switch, and it may overcurrent switch Q. So ultimately it may damage this circuit. So it may damage switch Q. So this is the basic problem which is happening with this circuit. So how to solve this problem? So now to solve this problem, I'll draw one territory winding, so which may solve this problem. So I'm drawing it over here instead of this primary circuit. Now I'm connecting territory winding at primary circuit. So in that, there will be battery as this EDC is there. And this is the winding. With that, I'll be connecting this switch. And here, there will be secondary winding. And this is what demagnetization diode. Additionally, that we are connecting. So this is what territory winding. This is territory winding. So that is what solving this problem of residual energy which is happening in this transformer. So basically, this is what the case which is happening in case of transformer core is getting saturated, and for that we connect this territory circuit, and that will be solving this issue in this. So sometimes you might be observing this circuit is given in some reference book, but that is the case because of residual energy, and we need to demagnetize it at primary side, and for that we need to connect this demagnetization diode, and this switch is connected over here, so it will not damage this switch, and demagnetization of this transformer core is happening, so it will not allow residual energy to get stored inside of this transformer. So this is what territory winding that we are connecting. Let us name it. It is so this is what we are connecting to solve this issue. Okay, so now let us discuss how this circuit functions. So this circuit that functions basically in three mode. In first mode, when the switch is on, primary and secondary both currents are flowing. So when this switch is on, so at the time primary and secondary current both are flowing. In this case of territory winding, even there will be a flow of primary current, as well as in this case even there will be a flow of primary current. So when this switch is on, primary current as well as secondary current, so that will flow like this. And polarity of this inductor, that will be plus minus like this. And as per this current, output will happen over here. So as this switch is on, primary current will increase gradually, as well as secondary current, that will increase gradually. And secondary current will be equals to inductor current. So when this switch is on, first case, voltage across switch, that will be minimum. Primary current, that will increase gradually from minimum to maximum. Secondary current even will increase from minimum to maximum. And inductor current, that will be similar to secondary current, that will even increase from minimum to maximum. And during that, there are two devices which is on. First device, that is switch, that is on, as well as this diode D1 that is on. So I am mentioning over here, this diode D1 as well as switch, both are on during that period. Now when this switch is off, this polarity of inductor is, it was initially plus minus like this, but when this switch is off, its polarity will change. Now it will be minus plus like this, and voltage across this switch, that will be almost 2 EDC. Initially there will be little spike and it will get to 2 EDC. So when this switch is off, initially there will be little spike and it will get set to 2 EDC. And at that time no primary current is flowing, and now secondary current, that will even not flow as primary current is not flowing. But now what will happen is this inductor polarity will change. Now it will get to minus plus like this, and current will flow in this loop. So current will flow in this loop because of inductor current. So ultimately here current in inductor that will decrease with respect to time. So here there will be two diodes which is functioning. Inductor current that is flowing, so this loop current will flow, so diode D2 is on. So diode D2 that will be on, and this demag, if we have this territory winding, in that case this demagnetization diode that will be on. So this demagnetization diode will be on, and it will be demagnetizing that residual energy which is there inside. So at that time demagnetization diode will be on, and if we keep off this switch, then this completely demagnetization will happen. So now there will be no residual energy, and once residual energy get to zero, voltage across that switch, that will now decrease to EDC. And at the same time, again primary current will be zero, secondary current will be zero, and inductor current that will decrease. And during that time period, only diode D2 is on. So there are basically three modes of operation. In mode 1, switch is on. In mode 1, this switch is on. Primary current and secondary current both will flow, both will increase gradually. Inductor polarity over here plus minus like this, and primary winding will be having plus minus this polarity. So two elements are on, this switch is on as well as this diode D1 is on. In second mode of operation, switch is off. So as this switch is off, primary current will be zero, secondary current will be zero. Only if this territory winding is there, then demagnetization current is happening by this diode, and this inductor polarity that will change minus plus like this, and this current will flow in this loop. So D2 will be on. So D2 and demagnetization diode is on. Once complete demagnetization of this primary core is happening, then this voltage that will get to zero across this transformer, and this voltage of transformer is zero, so only EDC that will happen to this switch. So once the demagnetization is zero, then this will be off again, only D2 will be happening on, and this current, inductor current, that will decrease like this. So there are three modes. In first mode, switch is on, primary secondary current will flow. In second mode, switch is off, demagnetization, and this inductor current will flow in this loop because of inductor polarity change, and then it will flow current in this loop. And in third mode, demagnetization of this core is zero, so only this loop current will flow. So that is how this circuit functions, and it will keeps on repeating. And once demagnetization of that core happens, only EDC voltage that will appear across switch. So that is how this circuit functions. Now let us discuss few advantages and disadvantages of this circuit. So here it need only one here advantage of this is it requires only simple driver circuit. Second advantage is it requires only one power transformer. only one power transformer. And disadvantage of this is it requires higher voltage rating of transformer. It requires high rating of transformer. And second disadvantage is transformer size is large. So large size transformer. And third disadvantage is it is costly. With respect to flyback converter, it is costly. So driver circuit is simple. It requires only one power transformer. So here multiple output could be easily taken. Disadvantage is high power rating transformer is required. Size of transformer is more and circuit cost is high compared to flyback converter. And this is even isolated. I have already told this is isolated forward converter. So this is basically forward converter, but here input and output is isolated. So we can use this circuit for multiple output. So that's why it is what isolated forward converter. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you have query regarding this topic, you can place comments. If I have understanding based on your query, definitely I'll get back to you. And if you have suggestion regarding power electronics videos, definitely suggest it over here. If I have understanding, I will place those topics to make sure like my students are learning from YouTube. Thank you so much for watching this video.